Hey there, everybody, and welcome back. So I've been waiting all week to be able to open up my big mouth and talk a little bit about what I consider to be certainly a very exciting way forward for the flight simulation community. You know, when I started flight simming over 20 years ago with Microsoft Flight Simulator 95, we enjoyed the luxury of consistent updates from Microsoft every few years to the flight simulation franchise. Each evolution had new tech, new planes, new features, and new opportunities for, at the time, a young aspiring aviator such as myself to be able to learn and grow. But after the release of Microsoft Flight Simulator X, Microsoft decided they wanted to try something a little bit different. And instead of the regular Microsoft Flight Simulator franchise, they instead decided to try a title known as Microsoft Flight. Ultimately, it was destined to utter failure. It had a closed environment that was locked down from third-party add-ons and third-party development. A lot of the add-ons that it did come out with were very poor quality. For example, some of the planes didn't even have virtual cockpits, and you could only fly in Hawaii or Alaska. So it went bust, and as a result, Microsoft disbanded its famous Aces studio altogether, and we've been in this standstill for about the last 10 years. Really, the only advancements we've had have been tweaks discovered by the community and third-party developers who created paid and freeware add-ons that brought new planes, textures, and sceneries to the old sim. But there was some hope, because we did have Dovetail Games who released Microsoft Flight Simulator X Steam Edition along with P3D from Lockheed Martin, and both offered some marginal performance gains, but mostly some vast improvements that improved the simulator's ability to operate competently with all the high-quality add-ons we'd been adding into our sims, from the likes of ORBX, A2A, Rex, PMDG, you know, airport developers like Flightbeam, etc., etc. But the problem that still remained is that no matter how much polish we put on the old FSX platform, it was still in dire need of a new lease on life and a complete evolutionary overhaul. The problem was that we had no idea when that overhaul was going to happen or if it would happen at all. So we all kind of viewed it as a pipe dream and accepted it as a long-distance shot. I mean, heck, we've been playing the same old CPU-bound game for the last 10 years. But at the end of 2014, there was some hope on the horizon. It was the next big thing when Dovetail Games announced that they'd be developing some sort of a new sim based on some sort of new technology. And we knew it wasn't going to be a bug fix or some incremental layer, but it was supposed to be a completely new platform built on Microsoft Flight technology. It was supposed to be modern and have next-gen performance, but really we haven't known too much about it for the last year, other than, you know, a couple of little tidbits of information here and there. Well, the time is finally here to be able to talk a little bit more in depth about it, and in short, I'm really, really excited about it. So let's take some time to discuss the next big thing in flight simulation, Dovetail Games Flight Simulator and Flight School. Let me take you to flight school. We'll learn to fly. So, over that year, and I know that intro music is kind of ironic considering what we're about to talk about, but, you know, over that year that we talked about from the end of 2014, the community was polled multiple times on what they wanted and expected in a new sim. So, there were thousands of suggestions, everything from, you know, I want better graphics to more specific requests like better API technologies. Those suggestions quickly, though, turned into questions from the community, right? So what's the new sim all about? What will it offer? How will it perform? What tech is it based on? How realistic will it be? Will it be arcadey, or will it just be for hardcore users? You know, the list goes on and on. So Dovetail Games reached out to us in the community to compile these desires and started building a team to deliver on as many of those desires as possible. And that started when they hired a guy named Steven Hood. He joined Dovetail Games as the creative director of this new flight simulation project, but he had come from making other AAA games. In fact, he led the famous F1 projects at Codemasters, which eventually turned into a number one title because of how high fidelity of a racing simulation it was. And of course, it looked beautiful. So now he was tasked with having the same success with a flight simulation title, which would be, as far as I know, a first in his career. But, you know, before we get into some of the finer details, let's talk about what's happened in the last 10 years altogether, right? I mean, 10 years, a lot has happened. I mean, we've seen cell phones turn into computing devices that are more powerful than PCs that came out just a few years before them. And we've seen this monstrous gaming industry built around games on mobile, console, and PC. And as a result, a lot of people enjoy really high fidelity virtual worlds that we would have never imagined possible. We also saw that the way games were played change as well, with some of the largest titles excluding single-player experiences altogether in lieu of multiplayer-only experiences as faster internet speeds became available in nearly every household across the world. We also saw the emergence of new ways to pay for and access these games take hold. This included digital download titles and what is now known as DLC, which replaced the old expansion packs we used to know that games had had for a long time, and instead it kind of centralized them into these incremental releases. But if you think about it in a way, flight simulation was one of the pioneering industries in this regard, as an entire business or entire businesses were built around add-ons for the old FSX platform. So they allowed flight simulation to mature into one of the most realistic and comprehensive and rich and robust environments in existence, as each one of these development companies specialized in their own sectors. So you had people making these true-to-life sceneries, photoreal environments, study-level aircraft, et cetera, et cetera. And the thing about that is that with that kind of maturity, it makes the idea of hitting the reset button a little bit of a difficult one. Hence the reason we see so much heavy fragmentation between the lines of FSX and Prepared and the likes of X-Plane, for example. It's so expensive to customize these sims to each individual user's liking that a lot of times it prevents simmers from running the sims simultaneously the way that they'd like. And the other thing is that creates a relatively difficult entry point for new users to the platform as well. If they want their sim to look like what you may see in some of my videos or some seasoned user screenshots, it could cost hundreds of dollars for them to even get started at that point. And the other thing is that as people became more seasoned, people became essentially veterans, there was even a sort of seniority complex, I guess you could say, where we saw some veteran users who could probably pass a check ride in a real 737 stand off from these new users who just want to learn the basics of flight simulation and may be behind them by, a whole decade. So that's where Dovetail Games' new offerings enter. Now, note that I said plural offerings. I say this because Dovetail Games will be releasing two new platforms for two different users that offers a path forward for both the new and the experienced alike. So these platforms will be known as Dovetail Games Flight School and Dovetail Games Flight Simulator. They represent the next evolution in flight simulation technology. And so as we talk about technology, I guess let's talk about some of that right now, because they have a lot to offer. So when they entered the market, when Dovetail Games entered the market, they acquired licenses to nearly all of the consumer technology that Microsoft had developed over the last 20 years in flight simulation. And after assessing the capabilities of each evolution, they decided it would be best to build this new sim on the base of FSX, which to this day remains the most complete and robust simulation in the Microsoft or legacy Microsoft portfolio to date. So these new sims will be full world simulators, okay? They will not be regional simulators. They'll be full world simulators. And we can finally say hello to 64-bit technology in the flight simulation or the Microsoft flight simulation core. We'll also gain DirectX 11 API technology to take full advantage of multi-core CPUs, programmable GPUs, and all the high-end computing power that are found in modern systems. There are also new features such as changes to the lighting engine, anti-aliasing, and a whole new modern multiplayer experience. Also, third-party support will be fostered by Dovetail Games to allow the amazing talents that exist in the FS community or the flight simulation community that I talked about earlier to enhance our virtual world. Now, the thing is that if you understand the basics of programming, you'll know that this evolutionary step into 64-bit means that backwards compatibility will not exist. But because it's built on the FSX core, there will be some familiarity in terms of resources the devs, and ultimately we'll have to see what the SDK and the SimConnects look like, but there should be some familiarity there for them to be able to take advantage of these new technologies and essentially evolve their offerings to this new platform. And, you know, there's a slew of new features that'll exist in these new sims that'll continue to be developed along the way. I can't speak about all of them right now, but I can assure you that I think the community will probably be excited to see what's finally possible in a modern simulator. So as we're talking about the simulators, let's start out with talking about Dovetail Games Flight School. So, you know, why does Flight School exist, right? Some senior or veteran flight simulation enthusiasts may not understand it, but it's actually pretty clear. Think about it. I mean, even when I started simming, I had watched way too much Top Gun, and I thought that every plane could climb like a fighter jet and that I would be like Tom Cruise, right? So I quickly learned that was not the case, and I had to learn how planes flew on an entry level, you know, elementary level of acumen. So the issue was that in FS95, there really wasn't much of a tutorial system, and I had to learn by reading books in my local library and asking real-world pilots, because there was no such thing as YouTube really back then. And even if there was, my internet couldn't have supported it, and Wikipedia didn't exist. So over the span of many months, I eventually learned how not to stall on takeoff, and over years, eventually learned how to land my Cessna back in Meeks Field, and eventually got around to flying a Lear 45. But those same challenges exist today for new users, although the internet has made learning a much faster process. You know, regardless, an interactive way of learning the fundamentals of aviation is still needed for virtual pilots. So this is why the folks over at Dovetail Games decided that they would provide Dovetail Games Flight School. It'll provide essentially a entry-level experience as if you were a real-world student pilot. From the day you walk into that flight school, and let's just say you had very little aeronautical knowledge to begin with, they'll take you through from ground school to, you know, progressing to your first solo flight, all the way to eventually possessing the competencies of a private pilot. And one of the cool things is that there'll even be a virtual instructor there with you in the cockpit, sitting next to you, in some of the most popular training aircraft. So, you know, this sim is not really intended to be for the seasoned pilot who knows how to fly a jumbo jet across the world, but instead helps someone begin their journey of being able to eventually do so, right? Now, Dovetail Games Flight School will come first in the lineup, and is expected to be out sometime in the early part of the second quarter of 2016. You know, we'll have to see whether or not there are really any add-ons or DLC that comes to that. But, you know, it's intended to be a relatively affordable entry point and a relatively simple to use and clean, straightforward sim. So what about for the rest of us, right? What about for the hardcore simmers? Well, that'll be coming as well. It'll be known as Dovetail Games Flight Simulator. And it'll represent the next step forward in general and commercial aviation or virtual aviation for pretty much everybody to enjoy. Now, that sim is still deep in development, you know, we'll be getting more details here soon. But, you know, it should offer a more robust and comprehensive environment. Of course, it'll be a full world sim. There'll be free flight and all the stuff that we love right now about the popular sims that are out on the market. And it'll still have some elements of Dovetail Games Flight School in it as well. So a newer pilot who is capable, but still learning, all the way to a pilot who knows how to fly a VOR approach in IMC conditions at night, you know, this sim should have it all. All the same technologies that'll be seen in Flight School will be there, and we'll have more information to share on that once we get a little bit closer to the release. You know, Dovetail Games will be giving us in the community a little bit more information, and I'll see if I can get my hands on some early builds to share with all of you. So, you know, look, they're going to continue to update us as they always have over the last year, even when they don't have any news to really share. They've always been great at communicating with us, and I think that this will be a really, really exciting year for us. So I thank you guys so much for tuning in. Stay tuned here, because next month I should have some cool stuff to share with all of you, and hope everybody has safe flights, and take care.